Welcome to Education Today. I'm Alex Thompson.
And I'm Corey Anthony, and we are seniors from Katanning High School in the Armstrong School District.
To start today's show, we have a very special guest with us, Frank Fabian.
He is employed in the Armstrong School District and coach of the Katanning High School football team.
Welcome to Education Today. Will you please introduce yourself?
Yes, my name's Coach Fabian. Thanks for having me today, guys. It's a pleasure to be here.
How long have you been coaching football?
This past season was my 12th year as a coach.
What made you decide you wanted to coach?
I was a player at the school down south there, Fort City High School. Played in college. Coming out, the first teaching job that I got at Red Bank Valley, just so happens the year that I was hired, there was an opening on the coaching staff there. So Coach Wasilowski, who was the coach there at the time, asked me if I wanted to help out, and I did, and kind of got the bug that first year and been coaching ever since.
What experience do you have personally in football?
I started in the Fort City Youth Program at age 10. I played all the way through high school and then went on to Gannon University and played there till I was 21. So I was 11 years and then obviously 12 years in coaching.
Tell us a little bit about this year's football team.
It was a very good run, so to speak. It was unexpected. You know, we had a group of guys that didn't have a lot of experience at the varsity level. So when you have that, you don't never know what you're going to get. But we had a hard working group. Then I think in the preseason we were picked to go 2-7. So to end up 9-0, it was special. But it was a special group. It was a good senior class that I think really had a tremendous work ethic. And I think that trickled down to our younger guys. And it was just a fun ride, unexpected ride. I don't remember ever entering a season where we had so many question marks to feel.
Yeah.
And a lot of those question marks turned into exclamation points for us. So that was a fun ride.
Tell us about some of the games in practice.
We have quite a collage of characters, I think, to say it correct, on our team. So practices were always, you know, upbeat. We're a little different than most high school teams. You know, we pump music into our practice. We're no huddle team, so it's pretty fast paced. You know, and with the amount of characters we have on the team, it was always a fun atmosphere. At least for me, it seemed like that. Very light. As far as the games, you know, a lot of fun. You know, obviously when you're winning, the games are more fun, but we had a bunch of guys that just competed. You know, we come down to the end of the season. We played two very good football teams in Valley and Shadyside. And to come out on the winning end of that was pretty special. The Shadyside game was particularly special. You get two 8-0 teams meeting that late in the season for all the marbles. You know, and then the game comes out 28-27, going back and forth. It was just a special time, and, you know, probably of all the games, that Shadyside game probably sticks out the most, at least to me.
What do you expect from players?
We're big on accountability in our program. We hold them accountable. And I guess we tell our guys effort and enthusiasm. You know, that's all we expect when they show up. You know, that 2 hours that they're going to be with us, we expect everything they have, and then to bring some enthusiasm with it. We have a saying in our program that, you know, practice is not something you're to survive. It's something that you're to use as a tool to get better, and I think you saw that with our team last year because we had a lot of inexperienced guys who got better as the year went along, and as a coach, you know, that's all you can ask for. You know, from the beginning of the year, I think, or from the end of the year to the beginning, our team was a much better team than it was early on, and, you know, I'm proud of that we did get better as the year went on.
How do you run your practices?
Like I said, we're no huddle team, so we like an up-tempo deal. We don't like a lot of guys standing around. You know, we usually start with some type of dynamic warm-up where our guys are moving, stretching, getting loose. We go into to what we call a screen drill, where we're kind of just repping plays on air, and then from there we go into an individual, and probably our individual periods where most of the teaching is done, where we're really installing the concept for the day. And then after that we go to a group period where we get the groups together, and again it's just repetition. And then we go to what we call an inside run period / 7-on-7, so where the linemen and the backs are split apart and they're down there repping and working together. And then finally, last half hour, we come together with the team, and we rep our plays for that week. So, you know, it's fast, it's up tempo, and we're just trying to get a lot of reps in as a short amount of time as we can.
Do you have any specific workouts that your linemen do that running backs don't, or the other way around?
A little bit. It varies a little bit. You know, one example of that is our linemen probably hit the sled a lot more. You know, their conditioning's a little different, where they're doing a shorter amount of work, because they, in a football game, linemen really don't run over 5 yards very often. So our conditioning, we come at it from a little different standpoint, where our skill guys are running routes and their conditioning may be a little longer in length to get some more aerobic conditioning, where our linemen, we'll put them down on the sled and have them push it a little bit and for shorter bursts, I guess, so to speak. 4 to 6 seconds is I guess the amount of time we like to condition them.
Do you feel the kids enjoy the program?
Well, you'd have to ask them. I would like to think so, but there's times where I'm sure they don't, and especially at practice, if you're dealing with 15, 16, 17-year-old kids, not everything's going to go as planned. And, the middle of the season, there might be a Tuesday or a Wednesday where we're a little sluggish, and I'm sure they don't like me very much that I have to get them in gear and maybe raise the voice a little bit and get them going. But overall, we seem to have a bunch of guys that enjoy being at the field house every day. Sometimes we have to kick them out, so that's always a good thing. But that's probably a question that they'd have to answer more so than me.
To you, what is the most rewarding part of coaching football?
Seeing a student athlete reach his full potential. When I got into this deal, I guess kind of one of the things I always constantly think about is our senior class. And everything that I try to do in our staff as well is we try to gear it towards we want our seniors to have the best experience possible, because they're only going to go through it one more time. And more often than not, their senior year is going to be the year they remember and reflect on. So everything we do is just trying to get that player, that student athlete, to reach his full potential.
Is there any specific teammate or kid that looks up to you the most?
Again, you'd probably have to ask that question to them. I do coach the quarterbacks in our program, so that's probably the group that I'm probably the closest with, just because I spend the most amount of time with them. Our quarterback in particular, Braden Toy, this year, he and I spend a lot of time. We've actually started right now watching some film, and then that will carry on to our quarterback camp. So just from a time standpoint, I probably spend more time with the quarterbacks than I do any other position group. So that'd be a question you'd have to ask him.
How has Katanning's record season impacted your personnel?
It seems like right now our weight room, we have our attendance has been excellent this off season. There seems to be a little buzz, an excitement. You take that, the Allegheny Conference Championship, you combine it with there's only 1 year left at Katanning High School. It makes for a pretty exciting time right now. And it seems as though, to me, there's a little bit more interest now than there was 2 years ago when I got here. So from that standpoint, it's helped tremendously.
What would you say to encourage more kids to join the track team in the coming season?
The track team? I tell all of our student athletes, I try to encourage them to go out and do something. get involved. You know, at Katanning High School, we're a double-A school. So the reality of that is we got to share our athletes. So right now we have, it seems, just so that this coming, the classes we have coming through, it seems to be a lot more baseball players right now. So we have a lot of our players playing baseball, but we do have some playing track. But, you know, as far as the answer to your question, my answer to them when they ask me is just get involved, do something. You're only going to go through high school once. Try to do as many things as you can.
Thank you very much for joining us today, Coach Fabian.
We're going to take a short break, and we'll be right back with Armstrong School District's Education Today.
I'm Indiana County Sheriff Bob Fyhawk. We're all proud of Indiana County, but we must be worried about the negative growth of drugs and alcohol abuse. It is the responsibility of all of us, parents, teachers, and community leaders, to provide the best possible education to our youth in the prevention of drug and alcohol abuse. The law is a deterrent, but education is still our best protection. Help keep Indiana safe and drug-free. For more information on how to talk to your kids about drugs and alcohol, go to theabovetheinfluence.com, brought to you by the Armstrong Indiana Drug-Free Communities Coalition.
Before I came to IUP, I had no idea what college would be like or what role I would play or where I'd be in the future. But when I came to IUP, everything changed. I met people who really made me feel like I belonged. I had great classes at a great nationally ranked university. Hi, my name's Megan Miller. I'm a fine arts major, and this is my university.
Hello, I'm Cindy McCray, director of ARC Manor Addiction Recovery Center. ARC Manor is committed to confidential quality services 24 hours a day, including fully licensed residential, partial hospital, and outpatient treatment programs. With 39 years of experience in addiction treatment, ARC Manor puts an emphasis on the needs of special populations, including women, co-occurring disorders, and adolescents. For more information, call 724-548-7607 or 800-323-1333. Brought to you by the Armstrong Indiana Drug-Free Communities Coalition.
Zane Dudak, running back, number 33.
Nick Bowers, wide receiver, 83.
Brady Crispin, wide receiver, number 6.
What are you doing to prepare for next season?
We're lifting a lot of weights. We have a good weight program.
Speed training a couple times a week.
We'll have 7-on-7 passing scrimmages in the summer.
Who do you look up to?
I look up to Nick Bowers. I want to be like him someday.
Adrian Peterson.
Chris Johnson.
All right. I'm Max Meckling, number 10 wide receiver for the Katanning Wildcats.
I'm David Crafton, number 56. Play linebacker and guard.
Do you plan on playing football after high school?
No, I do not.
I am planning on playing at St. Vincent.
What position, David?
Plan on playing offensive line there.
How many years did you play?
Well, right now for high school I played one, but I played back in midgets for about 3 years.
Played about 12 or 13 years since I was a little kid.
Were you happy with how your season went?
Impressed people. It was a pretty good season.
I think we did pretty well for what people predicted us to do.
I'm Logan Rahm, number 66. I'm the left tackle and defensive tackle.
I'm Brady Kirkwood, number 58, left guard and defensive tackle.
Who do you look up to?
I look up to Frank Fabian, I think, the most out of all the coaching staff, because throughout the week he teaches us to be the hammer and not the nail.
Yeah, I agree with Coach Fabian, but I'd have to say Dan Robb. This guy's dad, he's my coach back in junior high, so he taught me a lot of life lessons.
Were games and practices more fun with a winning season?
Yeah, they were fun, but they had a lot more pressure on us. They were more hard because of people had high expectations for us, so we kept winning. We had to keep the winning streak going.
Yeah, we had to take practices day by day, and we messed around, but Well, whenever it came down to game time, we got it just right.
What are some things that you did to prepare for a game?
Well, the last couple of years, we have a tradition going where we go to Emma Methlin's house and we hang out on her porch before games.
Yeah, we also we get Subway. His mom brings it to us. We get Philly cheesesteaks.
Logan Sluggle, number 24, wide receiver, defensive back.
Braden Toy, number 3, quarterback and defensive back.
How do you think your senior year next season will be?
If we work hard during the offseason, I think it'll be good. We just have to keep working hard.
I think if we stay focused, we'll do a lot better than we did this year, and maybe we'll win a playoff game. I was disappointed in that.
What activities did you do to help you achieve a winning season?
Just practicing hard, and we have a bunch of like pregame rituals, especially like the Thursday night ritual we do. It's a team thing, but you know, you really don't want to hear about it, so.
Definitely the Thursday night ritual. What else did we? What else did we do? Practice hard. Lifting during the off season. That's a big one.
How did a winning football season affect you as band members?
It made us want to be better, I feel, because like our football team is doing really, really good. So we had to match them, and I think we did. And there's also a lot more energy in the games.
It was nice because we got to cheer them on and be there and watch them win.
Like Cassie said, it gave us a lot more energy to play and be the best we could be.
I feel like it gave us a lot more school spirit and just let us have more fun at games.
I feel like we got to act like idiots, and who doesn't like to act like an idiot? I mean, come on, it's fun.
I feel like it gave us the most morale I'd seen here in 4 years, especially for us. So it made us want to play better, as she said. And the play better also made us just happier to be there.
I felt like we had more confidence because our football team had confidence, and it translated over to us because they were doing well, so it made us do well.
I feel the better that they played, the better that we marched and played our songs.
How did a winning football season affect you as a teacher?
Well, it was exciting to be teaching in a school where the team went undefeated during the regular season.
How do you, as a coach, plan on helping the boys achieve another winning season?
It started right after the season ended. We started our off-season lifting program. Coach Morris, Coach Fabian put a lot of time in, Coach Weitzel as well. With the lifters after school, most of the coaches are there till sometimes 6 o'clock or later. Whenever kids' schedules can make it, they come in and lift. And also, we have planned a speed training camp that the players will participate in starting in May and June. We'll do some speed training with our lifting as well. We have a full summer, especially June, of 7-on-7s. We're planning on going to a 7-on-7 camp this year that the kids are pretty excited about. Other than that, we'll just continue to do what we do, preparation, prepare, lift, train, and that hopefully will translate into another winning season this year.
How do you think having an undefeated football season influenced the school?
I thought it was just a great way to start the school year. School spirit was at an all-time high, and it was nice to have probably, maybe, arguably, the best season in the history of Katanning football.
You said about having a lot of school spirit. How do you think that the pep rallies were this season compared to others?
The pep rallies were probably the best I've seen in any school I've ever been at. The kids really took the initiative to run with them, and I thought it really got the morale up for the school, and not only for the students, but also for the staff as well. It got them even more excited about each upcoming game, and each week it built the momentum of it. It's just wonderful.
After last season, are you excited for the upcoming season?
Well, last year we won our first section title and almost 30 years. Well, this year our goal is we're going to win some playoff games this year. That's unfinished business that we're going to take care of, so I can't wait for Friday nights in the fall.
Turning face to stars and stripes, it's fighting back them butterflies, it's calling in the air, all right, yes sir, we
I'm Jen McCroskey. I'm a prevention specialist with the Armstrong Indiana Clarion Drug and Alcohol Commission. Hey parents, put your drug knowledge to the test. Attend a free teen scene program. Learn about signs and symptoms of drug use and abuse, current drug trends, resources for help, and view a large display of items where drugs can be hidden. For more information, call 724-354-2746 extension 309 to schedule a program today. Brought to you by the Armstrong Indiana Drug-Free Communities Coalition.
Before I came to IUP, I had no idea what college would be like or what role I would play or where I'd be in the future. But when I came to IUP, everything changed. I met people who really made me feel like I belonged. I had great classes at a great nationally ranked university. Hi, my name is Megan Miller. I'm a fine arts major, and this is my university.
Vince McCurry, Executive Director of The Open Door. Worried, scared, confused, not sure where to turn for help? The Open Door, a behavioral health organization, has a full range of addiction counseling services and mental health crisis intervention services which may be able to help. Call 724-465-2605 or 1-877-333-2470. The Open Door, steps towards hope, courage, and recovery. Brought to you by the Armstrong Indiana Drug-Free Communities Coalition.
We're back now with two students from Katanning High School, Alec Schaefer and Sean Shander, who are both members of the football team.
How long have you been playing football, Alec?
11 years, buddy.
How about you,
Sean? About 13.
What positions do you play in football, Sean?
Outside linebacker and backup running back.
Alec?
Wide receiver and cornerback.
What would you say was the most challenging part of football, Alec?
2 days. 2 days by far.
What about you, Sean? What do you think?
Definitely Saturday morning practices.
Oh, at 11 o'clock.
Oh, yes.
That was terrible.
Yes, they were.
Sean, how do you keep yourself motivated?
Well, I like the sport, so that's what really keeps me motivated because it's fun to play and everything.
Alec?
Music. Music in the locker room. Gets me going.
Describe for us one of your football workouts, like a practice.
Usually, first, we start off with our warm-ups, like stretching out. You know, you got to get stretched out before you start anything. And then we usually do our special teams. And then from there, we break up into our individual groups, like running backs, linemen, stuff like that. And then we go into our team towards the end of practice.
Oh, okay.
How do you feel about being the first undefeated team in recent times?
I guess it's kind of cool. I don't really notice it. It's not like getting a prize or something, like a present. It's just going with the flow.
Sean?
Yeah, it's just like you don't really notice it now. Like whenever during the season you did a little bit because you were like right after it happened, we were all pumped up, you know. But now it's just like you don't really realize it happened.
How close do you feel with your fellow teammates, Alec?
They're all my brothers. Brothers for life.
What about you, Sean?
Oh, we're all real close. If we weren't close, we probably wouldn't have won as many games.
Yeah.
As a group, what would be your favorite football memory?
Playing football with the boys.
Probably, definitely winning their district championship.
Oh, and beating Ford City really bad.
Do you plan on continuing football after graduation, Alec?
Maybe. Depends if my mom allows me.
What about you, Sean?
No, I'm going to play baseball in college.
What would you say to encourage people to join the football team?
Just play because it's so fun.
What other sport do you get to hit people? Like, whenever you want, you just run around and hit people. That's all you do.
Hockey?
Well, hockey's more challenging.
Hockey's more laid back.
Yeah, football, you get more intense.
Well, that's our show for today. Thank you all for taking time out of your busy schedules to join us. Our thanks also go out to the TV production students of Katanning High School, led by their teacher, Mr. Donald Swanson. They were our film crew today.
Please join us again next week for another look at Armstrong School District. DVD copies of this and all Education Today programming can be requested by contacting Chris Garitano, Multimedia Technician at Katanning Junior High School. Visit our website for updated information about the district and have a great week.